When Daenerys Targaryen was a little girl, her brother Viserys once feasted the captains of the Golden Company in the hopes they might take up his cause to reclaim the Iron Throne from King Robert I Baratheon. They ate his food and heard his pleas and laughed at him. Lord John Connington, exiled from Westeros during Robert's Rebellion, served 5 years with the Golden Company, but he is said to have drank himself to death. The Golden Company is said to now be made up of exiles and the sons of exiles. Some have been born into the company, but still consider themselves Westerosi. In Season 8, the Golden Company is brought to King's Landing by Euron Greyjoy, who is determined to impress Cersei. When the fleet arrived, its captain Harry Strickland met with Cersei and informed the Queen that roughly 20,000 men were in her service along with 2,000 horses. Unfortunately, the elephants could not make the journey via sea. Harry Strickland, who is portrayed by actor Mark Risman, oversees a division of the Golden Company on the Silence, Euron's flagship. According to the books, Harry is an exiled knight of House Strickland and he is also known as Homeless Harry Strickland. The Golden Company was originally founded by supporters of House Blackfyre, a branch of House Targaryen, who tried to seize the Iron Throne during the Blackfyre Rebellion. Harry's great-grandfather lost his lands in the First Blackfyre Rebellion, and then Harry, his father, and his grandfather were raised with the company in exile. The Golden Company has several connections to our current story, including Jorah Mormont, who pledged himself with the group before becoming an agent of Varys to spy on Dany. It's also worth noting that Essar Barristan Selmy, one of the most badass fighters Westeros has ever seen, once cut a bloody path through the Golden Company to fight their leader in single combat, which of course he won. So the Golden Company are not invincible, but they are renowned for their skills, have thousands of horses, use elephants as part of their battle plan, though not in Westeros, evidently, as elephants do not travel well in sea voyages, Cersei is told, and are definitely on par with speciality armies like the Dothraki and the Unsullied. The Golden Company, like so much history and lore, has a much more pivotal role in the Song of Ice and Fire book series than it has on the show. The company has taken up a lot of space on the pages of the later books of the series, and has made notable appearances in the Winds of Winter chapters that have been released. Thus, it feels like that the company could actually have important ramifications to the overall story. Right now, it's closely tied with the Young Griff storyline, which the show has not touched on. Young Griff, a character in the books, is possibly Aegon Targaryen, the son of Rhaegar Targaryen and Elia Martell, who was spirited away by the Hand of the King as a child before the slaughter by the Mountain. In the books, this is something Varys is aware of, and Aegon is the leader who he backs to rule Westeros, as Aegon's claim to the throne would be more secure than Dany's. When Cersei went shopping for a new ally, she found the biggest and best group of mercenaries she could buy with her latest loan from the Iron Bank, the Golden Company. Now that this elite private army has been ferried over from Essos on Euron Greyjoy's fleet, was this a good purchase on Cersei's part? Should Daenerys Targaryen and Jon Snow be worried? Davos originally recommended that Stannis hire the mercenaries to beef up his armed forces. He probably thought of them first because of their stellar reputation, which he must have known would be useful in persuading his reluctant king. Unlike some sellsword companies, the Golden Company is said never to have broken a contract. Their motto, "Our word is good as gold." Cersei is able to afford them because of gold stolen from Highgarden. Which is fitting, the men of the Golden Company like to wear their plunder, hence their name. They come resplendent with inlaid armor and golden arm rings, each ring signifies a year of service, wielding jeweled swords and decorating their tents with golden cloth. And pikes topped with gilded skulls. But Cersei should be careful, the Golden Company turns on patrons who don't pay up on time. The Lannister promised that they always pay their debts won't be enough with these guys. They once sacked the city of Kohor when a client didn't honor a contract. Unlike most other mercenary companies we've seen, the Golden Company decides whom to back based not only on payment but also on whomever it thinks has the chances of claiming the throne. This is one army that could have a mind of its own. Please like this video and subscribe to my channel. See you soon.